Hi friends, today we'll discuss another 25 important banking exam questions, answer with explanation also. What is meant by post-dated checks? So check drawn with a future date. For example, today is 6th June and if a customer written on a check as 10th June and he goes to the bank to withdraw money, bank will say it is a future dated because today is 6th June. The check is written on a future date. So we can't pay money for this check. So post-dated check is one which is drawn with a date which is after the current date. So today is 6th June. The date written on the check is 10th June. So it is called as post-dated check. So what is meant by stale check or stale demand draft? These are expired checks. You know, like any check or DD, if it is issued on one date, it is only valid for 3 months. So any check or DD date is less than 3 months from the current date, it is called as stale. For example, now it is June. So you got a check dated on 1st January 2021. So more than 90 days. It is called as stale check. What is meant by RBI mirror account? So all the banks, they'll maintain one account with RBI and they'll open another account in their bank. So mirror account means maintained for the reconciliation. Always these two accounts will be opposite balance. For example, in your RBI account, credit 10,000 means in your bank account, it should be debit 10,000. So amount will be same, but transaction type will be different. There it will be debit means here credit. If it is credit here means then in RBI it should be debit. Then only your reconciliation is correct. Which government has signed MOU with Bombay Stock Exchange to spread the financial awareness? So answer is Government of Jammu and Kashmir. The Bombay Stock Exchange signed for MOUs with Mission Youth, Government of Jammu and Kashmir on November 27 to spread financial awareness in their state. When was World Investor Week 2020 started by NSE? The period is November 23rd to 29th, 2020. So apart from NSE, BSE and depositories, CSDL, Stock Brokers Association are also observing the World's Investors Week during November 23rd to 29th. When was Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana scheme introduced? 22nd January 2015. The scheme was launched by our Prime Minister on 22nd January 2015 in Panipat, Haryana. These accounts can be opened at any India Post Office or a branch of some authorized commercial banks. You can open these accounts. How many years Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana scheme premium should be paid? It will be 15 years. You have to pay 15 years continuously in this scheme. Sukanya Samruddhi Yojana has a tenure equal to the time the girl child is 21 years. So on 21 years of the girl child, this amount will be paid. Or upon her marriage after attaining the age of 18, however, contributions only need to 15 years, but you can withdraw when your child becomes 21 years or the time of marriage, you can withdraw your money. What is meant by PPF account? PPF account means Public Provident Fund account. When did interest will be credited to PPF account? So government will calculate interest yearly once and same will be credited to PPF account. What is the maturity period for the PPF account? So the maturity period is 15 years, but you can renew for another 5 years also. The subscriber will get back his money after 15 years. The expiry of maturity period of 15 years along with the interest, which will continue to be added each year on the balance at the rate from time to time fixed by the government. So if you keep money in your PPF account, it can be withdrawn after 15 years only. How many times amount can be deposited in PPF account in a year? So you can deposit 12 times in your account. More than 12 times you are not allowed to deposit in your PPF account. What is meant by PMVVY? Pradhan Mantri Vaya Vandana Yojana. This scheme is for the pension scheme announced by the Government of India exclusively for the senior citizens age 60 years and above, which was available from 4th May 2017 to 31st March 2020. This scheme is only applicable to senior citizens. What is the minimum amount considered for the case to refer advisory board for the banking frauds? So in a bank, any fraud more than 50 crores, then these case will be referred to advisory board for banking frauds. Who is entered with the power to lay down instruction to the banks in India for audits is RBI. Recently, which bank license is cancelled by RBI? Shivaji Rao Bhosle Sahakari Bank, with effect from 31st March 2021. How many languages RBI Kayata was launched? It is launched in 14 languages. Multimedia public awareness campaign RBI Kayata Hai, which was launched in 14 languages to educate the public about safe banking and financial practices. So when customers are using debit card, customers are doing a e-commerce transaction, they are not supposed to share their OTP or CVV number, card number. These details will be covered under RBI Kehta Hai. What is meant by NBFC, non-banking financial companies? So non-financial banking companies majorly provide loans to the customers. Whether NBFC is allowed to accept demand deposit? Answer is no. NBFCs can't open savings and current deposits for the customers. They can give the loans only. Maximum tenure was fixed by RBI for the private sector banks MD and CEO position. 15 years only. So this is the maximum cap. Any person as MD or CEO for one bank continuously for the 15 years only, more than 15 years, he can't continue as a MD and CEO. News related to Sambandh Finserve, RBI cancelled license. RBI cancels license of Sambandh Finserve. RBI has cancelled the license of fraud hit Sambandh Finserve Private Limited, headquarters in Orissa. It was registered as an NBFC MFI. Which is the first foreign bank in India? HSBC. Which is the first Indian bank outside India? Bank of India. Bank of India was the first Indian bank to open the branch outside India at London in 1946. Which is the first bank introduce ATM? HSBC. The first ATM is in India was set up by HSBC in 1987 in Mumbai. Which is the first bank introduce checks in India? Bengal Bank. Bengal Bank established in 1784 was the first bank to introduce check system in India. What is the first bank introduce internet banking facility in India? ICICI Bank. ICICI Bank was the first Indian bank to provide internet banking facility. Thank you friends. If you like my video, please subscribe. For any support, call me or send me email.